I like getting to know my mom as an adult because there were so many holes of knowledge when I was younger. There were just so many things I didn't know. Like, I knew certain things, but didn't know the backstory of those things. I knew that she doesn't like white people. And I could take some guesses as to why. But it was never explained. One day we were in her car and she stopped to let this old white couple pass in front of us. And she lets out this deep sigh like, ugh, white people. And I was like, what's wrong? They're not even talking to us right now. And she goes, memories. And that's where the conversation ended. And she would do that a lot. She'd just chalk things up to memories. And I would never follow up and ask what those memories were. And I was so young and just like left to my own devices. I would like make up stories as to what I thought she was saying. Like, I imagine if I asked her, like, Mom, what do you mean when you say memories? She'd say something like, well, Sashir, when I was 11 years old, I went to the public library in Little Rock, Arkansas, and I was by myself. And this old white man came up to me and put his hand on my shoulder. And something about his hand on my shoulder and me holding the book sucked us into the world of the book. And we landed in this magical forest where the trees could talk to us and the dirt tasted like licorice. Now, we didn't know where we were, so we split up to find help. And the old white man went one way, and I went another way, and I found this cave, and inside the cave was this big, beautiful dragon with a purple tail and glittery wings. And she spoke to me and said that she would take care of me if I just stayed there with her. I lived with that dragon for the next 3 years of my life. And on one of our morning walks, Crackle and I, that's her name, Crackle the Dragon, we saw the old white man. And I don't know what kind of adventures he went through on this 3-year journey in this magical land, but he looked totally different. He was shirtless and he was ripped and he was carrying a bow and arrow. And he saw me with Crackle and he thought I was in danger. And he shot Crackle through the heart. And I cried and said, "You don't know what you're doing." But shooting the dragon through the heart is what we needed to get back to reality. So we landed back in the library. And the old white man returned to his job as the Little Rock public librarian. And I started classes at a segregated high school. And that's why I don't like white people.